Hi friends, Tendi here. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new, welcome and show your girl some love by subscribing to the channel. In this video, I'm gonna give you guys 10 tips to keep your house clean. Number one, make your bed. I suggest you do this the first thing before you get out of your bedroom and start taking care of the business of the day. A wise man once said, making your bed gives you a sense of accomplishment that will help you to do more and more tasks as the day progresses. I personally enjoy coming home to a fresh, nicely spread bed. It just gives me a sense of calmness, especially after a very long day at work. Seriously, guys, for myself, if I don't make my bed the first thing in the morning and I leave it laying like that all day, I just feel like I am still sleeping. I don't know if it's just me, but psychologically it just messes up with my mind. So I would rather do that the first thing in the morning. Number two, trash items that are expired or broken, or donate those items that you are no longer using anymore. The thing is, it's very important to let go of the old items that we are no longer using so that we can make room for the new thing that we are buying. On to number three. Invest in storage baskets or boxes or furniture that has storage on it. So this helps to contain all your stuff or items in one place. They won't just be laying around everywhere in the house, especially kids' toys, books, blankets, pillows. Number four, have few items on your counters, and this can be in the kitchen or the bathroom. For example, in the kitchen, if you're not using small appliances like the blender, the crock pot, just put it away in the cabinet. That way you are going to have less items on the counters and it makes cleaning very easy. So in the bathroom, especially on the sink counters, organize your items or cosmetic in a tray instead of having them cluttered all over the counter. And so when you're cleaning, you just lift the tray and then you just clean underneath and put it back. On to number five, put away items on one touch. And this means no chair syndrome. For example, if you're coming back from work or just changing clothes, put them back either in the closet or in the laundry if they are dirty, and don't pile them on the chair for later. This routine has actually helped me personally because I used to have a chair syndrome. I don't know if you've ever heard of that. So what I would do if I'm coming back from outside or anywhere, I'll just get in my room and then remove the clothes, put them back on the chair. That was my wardrobe, kinda. I would put them on that chair, and then the next day the same thing, or if it's a Sunday and I'm trying outfits for church, I'll just remove it. If it doesn't work for me, I'll put it back, I'll try another one, and I'll put it back on the chair, and at the end of it all, it will be a mountain of clothes that needs to be put back in the closet. And that was just a daunting task for me. So I decided that I was not gonna do that anymore, and then started to just put away clothes immediately and not wait for another time to do that. So you can try this at home. I tell you, this is going to be a game changer, and you thank me later. You're welcome. Number six, clean as you go. If you ever remember anything that I have said in this video, get this one straight. By the time that you finish cooking or eating, you will have less work to do and it's not gonna be overwhelming at all. Number seven, clean dishes before going to bed. So this one is just a continuation with number six, clean as you go. So let's face it, guys, it's a good feeling to wake up to a clean kitchen, right? Well, for me personally, what I do every day in the evening after dinner, I make sure that I clean the dishes, the sink, wipe the breakfast table, clean the stove. And this just reminds me of my mom. When I was still at home before I got married, she would always say, "Tendi, what clean the stove?" That means, Teddy, have you cleaned my stove? She was so particular about her stove. So that really trained me. Thank you, Mom. So another thing that I do in the night, I would also sweep only the kitchen floors. Unless I have time, I can go to the living room, but I always sweep the kitchen floors. Number 8, no shoes in the house. I tell you, this habit makes a huge difference because it reduces the amount of dirt trapped in the house. Our shoes pass through different areas when we are out and about, so it's better when we get home to take off the shoes and put on house shoes. I know this is a very controversial issue and it varies between household to household. Let me know in the comments below if you guys take off your shoes before getting in the house. Number 9, fold laundry immediately after taking it out from the dryer. That way you will not need to iron and you will not have piles of laundry laying on the couch or in the baskets for weeks. Number 10, take care of the mail. Don't let junk mail accumulate. Those get rid of immediately, even while you're still outside. You are allowed. Let me know in the comments below which tip or habit you like the best. That's it, friends. Thank you for sticking around till the end and give this video a thumbs up if you learned something new today and if this information was helpful to you. And remember to subscribe and to click the notification bell so you can be notified when I upload another video, and I'll love you forever. Thank you so much for watching again. See you next time. Bye.